The appellation, a man of the people, aptly describes Professor Matthew Idowu Ajibero, a name that became synonymous with academic excellence, leadership, and philanthropy. Born on 21st September 1950 to the family of Chief Obapumin Ajibero and Princess Mary Adeyemi Ajibero, the one-time rector of Kogi State Polytechnic and special advisor to the state government on higher education, became a household name with his achievements as an educationist, human developer, community mobilizer, lover, and friend of the poor, just to mention a few.
He was a lover of humanity, a good father, a good husband, a good friend, a good Christian. He's good in all, a good educationist. In all ramifications, he was fantastic. He lived a good life. As Adventist, if you see the testimony, the tribute in the church, and even in the program, you will know he was a special person. He wasn't born great, but he achieved greatness by dint of hard work. So he was a great man.
Loved by many, Ajibero's death came as a rude shock at a time when the community, friends and family looked up to him as a well of wisdom and inspiration.
A very humble man, courageous, down to earth, and highly intelligent. I've been close to him, I've been following him for more than 20 years now. And you know, we even have the same surname. So people tend to think we have the same parents. But you know, the community is a very homogeneous one, interrelated somehow. So he's a community person to the core. And I did benefit from his patriotism. To cap it all, when I became the KDU president, he called me and gave me a lot of advice. Him being a community person understands our people very well. And he did pass on to me some of those qualities of his. Even in all my activities, sometimes some of them get misunderstood. He will call me and offer me a lot of advice and encouragement too. So he's one person I will miss so much.
Having touched many lives, the funeral of the late Don attracted people from all walks of life. The Oba of Kabba, Oba Solomon Owoni, traditional leaders, friends from political, social, religious and academic bodies were all in Kabba to sympathize with the Ajiberos. It was a solemn night at his residence, where a wake was held. praise songs, hymns and words of encouragement from officiating priests set the tune for the funeral mass.
Nigeria will not be where we are. Unfortunately, whatever be the name of that devil that is directing the affairs of this country as of now, God is capable of solving the problem. As no problem is greater than God.
September 21, the body arrived at Sacred Heart Catholic Church, Kabba, for a mass. The church was a place Ajibero, while alive, made his second home. At a young age, he learned and memorized the Latin prayer and hymns. He later became a mass server. His love for humanity and the Catholic Church also manifested in his embrace of the knighthood in 1990. Cardinal John Olorunfemi Onaikon and others at the church paid glowing tributes to him.
The thing with Ajibero is that he was a quiet achiever. He definitely achieved a lot, but the achievement didn't just come by chance, like it was everybody is saying. It's by hard work, but also because of the kind of person he is, his character. And his character is clearly one of somebody who is humble, honest, and religious in the positive sense of the word. We see in Ajibero, somebody who has taken his Catholic religion very seriously. It has affected his life, his academic life, his social life, his political life, and of course, in the area of church order. So much so, he was a grand metropolitan knight. For us in the church, we know what that means. It's the highest point that a lay person can reach in our church. Ajibero was a politician, very skillful. He was involved in making sure that as far as he could, things would go well. He was never party to any group of criminals. The leadership role that God has has given him was always for the good of the people. And in the case of our own little village in Kabba, it was very much an element of unity. Brought all of us, brought all the, you know, we have clans in Kabba, and we have made that a horrible thing. He has managed to weave the tribes, the clans together.
Idowu Ajibero was a man of his own class. He was a distinguished knight of St. Mulumba. He was our metropolitan grand knight. I was his deputy. And he piloted the affairs of the Metro Council very, very well. He's a very religious man. He's quite committed both in his faith and to the order to which we belong. And he lived a very useful life. He impacted on a lot of people positively. So we pray that God will grant him eternal rest in his bosom.
He has been a man of good faith and a very esteemed brother among us. He has done so many things. In fact, the story everywhere is that the man is good.
Professor Matthew Idowu Ajibero has paid his due. He contributed in all areas of our life. For the community development, educational development, the development of Kogi State, he did very well. And that is why His Excellency Alaye Abelo insisted that he must be represented and be part of the final journey to wish him to rest in peace. We truly appreciate what he did, particularly in getting so many people into school, paying their school fees, putting a lot of people to be well, established in businesses. All this he did, and you can hear the testimony in the church that he did well as a follower of Christ. We are proud of him.
We gather here to commend our brother Matthew to God.
After 70 years on earth, the body of the one-time rector of Kogi State Polytechnic returned to the earth after a graveside service.
In the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead.
Friends and former colleagues described him as an exceptionally good man.
Relationship with staff and students. As you can see, a lot of staff from Kogi State Polytechnic are here. That is recognition that at least the man was good when he was there. And the man that left almost about 10 years ago, you can see still maintained good relationship with staff. And I'm sure he had laid a very solid foundation, the legacy that I believe that some of us are building on to profit. So I think he was a great man, and we'll miss him a lot from Kogi State Polytechnic. In terms of infrastructure and academic development, of course, when you go to Kogi State Polytechnic, he opened the gateway for our relationship with TEDFUN. And I'm sure we are building on that. A lot of projects that are going on in Kogi State Polytechnic today, he was the father of the projects.
Like the library we have, the first library, Kabba Library, was the person who initiated it because he was a librarian. And of course, like now, he's from Gweleko. We did a lot of community service to his Gweleko. We are all from Gweleko. You know, Gweleko is there. So, and like when the university was to be cited, I know the role he played for it to be cited in Kabba, though it didn't materialize. But those of us close to him were aware of the role he played. So he was really a community man to the core.
Sir Professor Ajibero. As a man with too many sides. He was too good to a fault and too generous to a fault. He hailed my family as part of his own family. Apart from being Catholics together, you can see us. I'm a member of the Knights of St. Mulumba, Nigeria, of which he was a member too. a metro granite for that matter, while I'm a granite of St. Luke Abuja Sub-Council. If you were in the church, I'm sure you heard a lot of things that were said about him. But all I can wish him is to continue to pray for him or pray with him that may God Almighty grant him eternal rest and console the family he left behind. It is a big blow that none of us expected will blow on this community like this. So the Knight of Zambulumba will miss him, the community will miss him, the university committee will meet him, and every other person that has one or two things to do with will miss him.
He's an educationist by excellence. He's a peacemaker. He's a lover of people. The community will certainly miss him. Even before I knew him, I've heard so much about him. How he facilitates admission, how he gives people job, how he helps in the community. Even when I became the provost of the college, I knew the part he played between me and the previous provost. Definitely the community will miss him greatly because he's a good community leader.
He was, in the words of his children, a father with many qualities worthy of emulation.
The main thing will be his kindness, his love for humanity, his love for Kabba as a community. There's just too many things that I used to remember him because he had too many qualities that one, you know, wish to emulate.
Honestly, I will remember Daddy for, you know, his love for us. I remember him for his humility, his service to the Catholic Church, service to humanity, and his respect for everybody, no matter who you are or where you're from. Due to him, I thanked him for being the perfect role model. So what that means is that we just have to carry on with what he has done and improve on it. That's what we intend to do.
His care, everything about him, his encouragement, his guidance to the church, to the community, to the church. He was always very committed, a very strong Catholic.
It was wonderful. He was exceptional. He was one in a million. He was the best father you could ask for. In the tribute I wrote, I think I wrote something about, even if God had given me the opportunity to mold the perfect dad in quotes, I probably won't have still been able to craft someone as wonderful as he is. So he's one in a million, basically. The phone calls, the little jokes, you know, the stories, the advice, you know, those are all the things I'm really going to miss about him, and a whole lot more, actually.
The late knight and professor will be remembered for his numerous awards and accomplishments in all the fields he traversed at home and abroad. In 2016, he received an award of excellence in education by Kogi State government on the occasion of the 25th year anniversary of the creation of Kogi State. He also received a merit award by Catholic Men Organization of Catholic Diocese of Lokoja and Kwame Nkrumah Leadership Award by the All African Students Union, among others. The celebration of his life continued at Kabba Township Stadium, where a reception was held. When you Friends and groups such as Kabba Development Union are already making arrangements to immortalize him.
And I think we had the opportunity, we would have made the announcement today. But by the grace of God, once we go back, you come to Kogi State Polytechnic, you see that visibly.
He's somebody we need to honor so that we don't forget him in a hurry. So the library that he helped the community to establish, before handing over to us, we will name it after him. And we are also committed to making a statue of him in front of that library by the special grace of God, because he did a lot for this community. His name alone opens the door for us.